See, in permutation and combination chapter, we studied one standard or universal concept, that is 0 factorial will always be equal to 1. Okay, 0 factorial will be equal to 1 always. But why is it so? So since we know the number, mathematics is what? Study of numbers only. Study of numbers and patterns. So here we can observe one pattern. See, I'll start with 5 factorial. Suppose 5 factorial will be what? 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, isn't it? And then 4 factorial will be 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. This will be 24. And this will be 120. 3 factorial will be 1 into 2 into 3. That is 6. 2 factorial is 1 into 2. 2. 1 factorial means 1, that we know. Now, we'll start from the reverse order. 120 divided by 5 will give 24. See, 120 by 5 will be 24. Okay, so this is what? 120 by 5. Okay, then 24 divided by 4 will give 6. 24 divided by 4 will give 6. Now 6 divided by 3 will give 2, isn't it? So 2 is the answer. Now 2 divided by 2 will give 1. This is 2 by 2 equal to 1. Okay, now to get 0 factorial. To get 0 factorial, this 1 divided by 1 we should do, and that is 1. So this is how interesting pattern we'll get for 0 factorial. So remember, 0 factorial will always be equal to 1.